friends, this is Rakesh from Let's Make Learning Simple channel. Now we are going to discuss some work, abstract factory design pattern, theoretically, and also using some real-time examples, and also using some code snippet. In the next video, we will try to explain this abstract factory design pattern using some program, using Java language. So please try to watch the video also for better understanding. So here, first, what is abstract? Abstract means hiding. So for example, consider a real-time case. Suppose if you want the fan to work, what will you do means you will try to put the fan switch. Here, you don't know what the technical things that is happening behind the fans working. But you are getting the actual output. You need the fan to work. That's it. The technical inner details are hidden from the actual client or customer. So that's the meaning of abstract. And what's a factory? Factory means it's like a provider. For example, if you have some problem, medical problem. For example, if you have fever, means what you do means you will try to go to the nearest medical shop and you will try to tell your problems. So like I have some fever and cold, so I need some best medicine. That medical shop owner or medical shop member or representative will try to analyze the problem and he will try to, or ERC will try to return the best medicine possible. Here, that medical shop representative is the actual factory. The factory provides the object based on. So here types of fever, cold, like that. So this is the meaning of abstract and this is the meaning of factory. So what is the abstract factory mean? So here, abstract factory means super factory which creates other factories. So we have already covered about the factory design pattern in the previous video. Suppose if you haven't watched that video, please try to watch that video and then come to this video for better understanding. So what super factory? So for example, consider another example. Here consider I am the soap manufacturer company. I need to manufacture some soap. So what I will try to do is, I will try to divide that my company into n number of companies, n number of factories to be exact. So one company tries to manufacture wrappers, the soap wrappers, and the another company tries to manufacture the soap raw materials, and another company tries to manufacture the other raw materials. The fourth company will try to combine all the raw materials and try to produce soap. So here, actually the four factories which are working under one single factory. So that's one single factory is called super factory or abstract factory that will try to manage or will try to pick the requirements from the clients or customers and will try to return the appropriate factories. So the super factory will try to get the output from all the factories and it will try to make it as a final product and will try to release like that. So that's the gist of the abstract factory design. We will try to explain that using this real-time example and also using some code snippet. So this is a real-time example. So I have classified animals into two types, domestic and wild. Under domestic category, cat and dog belongs to the domestic category. Lion and tiger belongs to the wild category, wild enemy category. So actually, technically, animal is an interface. So it has a method called public int get number of friends. The actual implementation for that method would be present in the lion concrete class, tiger concrete class, cat concrete class, and dog concrete class. These classes would return the actual number of legs. For example, cat, dog, lion, tiger, all of those have four legs, so it will try to return the four legs. If some animals have four, six or eight legs, means it will try to return the number of legs. So this is the actual example. So these classes would be managed by the domestic animal factory. For example, if a customer is going to a shop, if a customer is going to the medical shop and is trying to sell his problems that I have some cold and have fever, but medical shop representative would return some appropriate medicine. Similarly, a client or customer is going to a domestic animal factory and is trying to get some domestic animals. So the client is telling that I need an animal of four legs of weight 25 kg. So you will try to return the dog object because that would be the more appropriate and compared to cat. Similarly, for a white animal factory, based on the requirements, it will try to return the appropriate object. So the requirements are 4 legs and 50 kg. The appropriate object would be lion or tiger. It depends. These two factories will be managed by the animal factory. So animal factory is the abstract for this to the outside world. To the outside world, it doesn't know whether there's an animal factory, wild animal factory or domestic animal factory. It's very abstract. So the requirements for this animal factory would be, I need a wild animal, first requirement, and then the number of legs should be 4, and the weight of that animal should be less than 100 kg. Based on these 3 requirements, this animal factory would process those requirements and it will try to choose the appropriate abstract factory, appropriate factory. So here the wild animal factory would be the more appropriate factory, and it will try to this wild animal factory try to return the appropriate object for the criteria. The appropriate object would be lion, like that. So this is the abstract thing. So similarly, if you can see another real time example, this is the medical representative. So if I am the customer, I am the person who is going to the medical shop and I am trying to ask that I need a medicine for cold, fever, ages 25, like that. Based on this requirements, it will try to choose the according factory, whether light fever factory or heavy fever factory. Using the light fever factory based on other requirements, it will try to return the appropriate medicine. So we can relate n number of examples using abstract factory design. So actually, abstract factory design is implemented in Java libraries. So if you are trying to read some XML files using DOM parser, then you would have used the abstract factory, because document builder factory is an abstract factory. Using this factory, you can get the actual factory object. Here the actual factory object is docfact by calling get instance method. Using that actual factory object, you can get the concrete objects. Here using new document builder, I'm getting the concrete object for this docfact object. So using the concrete object, we can do n number of operations. So this is the real time example. This is the code snippet where abstract design pattern was implemented in Java library. Please try to watch the next video also, because in the next video we'll try to explain how we can implement the abstract factory design using a simple program in Java language. Thank you.